Everybody, welcome to another Affinity photo tutorial. This is the first one for 2022, and we're going to do this picture that I have on screen at the moment. So as usual, let's get started. Going to start off with our astronaut here, and as you can see, I have already cut out my astronaut, and I use my selection brush tool over here to cut the astronaut out, and I did come down here to the composite blue channel, which gave me a better contrast to cut that out. So basically I've got my astronaut cut out here, so I can turn that one off. The only thing I'm going to do with this astronaut at the moment, going to zoom in on the face shield here all the way in, grabbing my pen tool, making sure that it's in smart mode up here. And I might just zoom in a little bit more, and I'm just going to make a selection around the face mask or shield that we have here, just with my pen tool all the way around the edges. You can take a little bit more time than me and get this a little bit straighter. And once I've gone all the way around, I'm going to come up here to selection and create that selection. If I want to tidy that up a little bit, I can come over here to my selection brush tool, very small brush, and just fix up those little areas that I missed with my pen tool here, making that a little bit better. Holding my option key down just to tidy that up in that corner there. So there we go, I've got a good selection there. So what I'm going to do with this selection is make a copy. So Command J, so I've got a copy of the face mask here. Get rid of these marching ants with a Command D. And I'm going to add a layer effects down here on this little icon here. And I'm going to pick Inner Glow. Click on Inner Glow, clicking on the color. I want a sort of orangey yellow color. That one looks pretty good. And I'm going to turn the radius all the way up and the intensity down a little bit, just so it looks like that face shield is got sort of a light on the inside. On that outer glow, I'm going to do the same. Pick that sort of same color. Let's add a little bit of outer glow, but turn the intensity down on that as well. Clicking off that and Command Zero. So that's all I'm going to do for my astronaut. And I will have the astronaut all cut out available on the Buy Me a Coffee site for you if you don't want to do all the cutouts yourself. So that's our astronaut done. So let's move over to our next picture, which is the picture of this window. And as you can see, I've already done the cutout of all the windows. So I'll just show you quickly how I did that again. And I used my pen tool again on smart mode, zooming right in, and you can go all the way around the window and just make a cutout of that window. So all the way around. Again, I'm doing this fairly quickly, so you would take a lot more time than what I'm doing here. So all the way around to that first node there, and then hit on selection. But also unlock that layer there. I'll turn off my background layer so it works properly. So on that background, unlock it, and then you can hit delete and get rid of the marching ants. And you can see my cutout's pretty rough. So if you wanted to clean that up a little bit, you could use your erase brush tool with everything on 100% flow and hardness. Small brush, if you just click in one little area, hold your shift key down, come to the end, and you can clean that up fairly quickly. Again, click in one little area, and you can clean that up fairly quickly. Just going around, cleaning that window up. And you need to do that for each of these windows, including the round window there. So as I said, I'll turn that off. I've already done my cutout here, so let's move on with this one. And I'm going to just zoom in on these little buttons over here, and I'll grab my selection brush tool here and make my brush a little bit bigger. And I'm just going to select these buttons here. Holding my shift key down, I can continue to select each of these buttons all the way down. And this is going to be a very small detail, but it's sort of not a bad detail. So let's go around this one here as well. Hold my option key down so I don't have that black button there. That looks pretty good. So let's zoom out. What I'm going to do is copy that with a Command J. So I've just got a copy of the buttons here. we can now get rid of the marching ants. And on that button layer, I'm going to change the blend mode to negation. And then on that button layer, come down here to FX, layer effects, again, inner glow. Let's click on that. This time I want a really red color and turn up the radius quite a bit and the intensity down. Again on the outer glow, we'll have red again and turn up that radius and the intensity down. And it just gives sort of the look that those buttons are in alarm. And you can do that to any of these buttons here on the console, wherever you want a little bit of glow. The next thing we're going to do on our window, come back to our background layer here and grab the freehand selection tool. Going to start cutting bits of this window out, just random bits here like this, and use my Command X to cut and then my Command V to paste that back in and get rid of those marching ants. On my Move tool, I'm just going to move that piece out, turn it and move it somewhere else. Back on my background copy, I'm going to continue to make a few of these cutouts. So again, freehand selection tool, cut out this bit here. It can be sort of ragged, doesn't matter. Command X and Command V to paste that back in, get rid of our selection. Onto our Move tool and then move that somewhere else up here, maybe a bit smaller. Make sure we come to this background layer every time we want to use the selection brush tool to cut out these pieces. And one more over here. There we go, that's not too bad. So now we've got all these pieces cut out. So now we can take all of these pieces, clicking on our buttons here, holding our Shift key down and Command G to group them. And let's call that space window. And we're ready to bring this over to our next picture. So let's copy that whole group, Command C. I'm over here to this picture and then clicking on the background, right on top, Command V. Let's grab our Move tool. Make this all a little bit smaller so we can see what we're doing. And let's place our window in place. Make it a little bit bigger. And I think it looks good. About there, looks pretty good. Okay, while we're here, we'll add a mask onto our space window here. Grabbing our brush, coming over to our brushes, changing our brushes back to basic and a nice soft brush. We'll be painting in black and our flow will be about 10%. What we're going to do is just blend this into this picture here now so it's not as rough. We'll just go around and blend that in, getting rid of those harsh lines. Making our brush a little bit smaller. If you make a mistake, back to white, just paint a bit of that back in there. Okay, I'm pretty happy with that. So what I'm going to do now is on this background layer, add an exposure adjustment, clip that to the back, and then I'm going to darken that up quite a bit, just blending that in. Back on our space window layer, I'm up here to select and selection from layer. That's going to reselect all of that window. What I'm going to do is come here and go invert selection, grab my erase brush tool, everything's on 100%, and click on this window, the background layer here, not the window layer, the background layer, and let's just erase everything that's inside of that window there. Okay, Command D to get rid of that, so everything's starting to look pretty good. On our space window, let's add an exposure level to that as well and clip it to the space window. Let's just brighten that up a tiny little bit so we can see these controls. That's okay. And I might adjust the exposure on the background as well, maybe lighten that up a tiny bit, maybe about there. Looks pretty good. Okay. We're ready to bring over this picture of space now. So I'm going to copy this picture, Command C. Coming back to our picture here, I'm going to bring this all the way, just move this all the way down the end so I know exactly where it is. And I'm just going to paste that with a Command V, that picture of space, and drag it down to the bottom. On the Move tool, let's just make that a little bit smaller, but make sure we're covering all of that window. So We're going to grab our second space picture. So we'll grab our second space picture now, which is this one here. And again, Command C, come up to our picture. Again, right on top of the first space picture, Command V. This one I'm going to change to screen and then just drag that out. Just move it around a bit till I can see that little planet in the corner there. That looks pretty good. And I'm going to drop the opacity on this one to 50%. So we've got our sort of window, Command Zero, got our window, our space window looking pretty good at the moment. So now we're ready to bring in our astronaut or spaceman. So let's click on that spaceman that we've got here. Let's group these two together, clicking on that shield that we did, the face shield, and on the background, and Command G, and we'll call him Spaceman. And now we can copy that group, Command C, back to our main picture, and then right on top, we'll paste him right on top. Making sure on our move tool, we can resize him and place him sort of in the middle here. That looks pretty good about there. That size. Okay, on our spaceman, we're going to add an exposure layer. Clip it to our spaceman, and we're going to make him a lot darker. I'm also going to add a selective color down here. Selective color. Clip that to our spaceman as well. And make sure we're on neutrals. Under here should be clicked on neutrals. And the cyan I'm going to make 35, and the yellow I'm going to make minus 20. So I'm just going to click off that, and that's helped blend that spaceman in a little bit. While we're here, again on the spaceman, another exposure, and clip that to the spaceman, and then this one really bright. And then invert that with a Command I, so we've got that inverted. Grab our paintbrush again, softer brush, going to be painting in white, and we want the flow and everything to 100%. So I'm going to have a fairly big brush about that size, and I'm just going to add some highlights to my spaceman here. Down the hose and his arms. Okay, happy with that. So now what we're going to do is, remember we did some of these pieces that we cut out. So I'm going to click on one of those and come to my move tool. I'm going to move that on top of the spaceman. So I've got some of these pieces floating inside here. I'm going to move a few more. So this one up as well. That one's over here. So I'll move that one maybe down here. This nice big one will move up to the top. And make that a little bit bigger and move that down here. So we've got some of these pieces floating on the inside and some floating on the outside. And some of these other ones, we can just move them so we can see them a little bit better. And let's just move that one maybe a little bit smaller and move it up into this corner here. So that looks pretty good. Okay, so now we've got some of our bits floating around, so that's looking pretty good. Let's bring over our next picture, which is going to be the picture of this glass here. So we can just copy that one, Command C, over to our main picture, again, right on top, Command V. Let's change the blend mode to screen and make that a little bit smaller and turn it around. These glass ones are going to start by putting them under the window here. So we've got them looking like they're outside. I'm going to make a few copies, Command J. I'm just going to keep turning them around a little bit just to make them look a little bit different and different sizes as well. So maybe about like that. Okay, a couple more. So that glass is on the outside there. So now I'm going to make another copy, and I'm going to bring this copy all the way up the top. So then I've got some glass on the inside as well. Command J. Go around and put some of that glass. This one can be a bit smaller. Just going to hide that hand there behind the glass because I don't have that hand. So I'll hide that there. Command J again. Turn that one round and make it smaller up into the corner here. And then just a couple more down this side. One more. Just on this side down here. Command 0 to make that a bit bigger. So that is looking pretty good. So let's just group all this glass on top here. Command G and call that glass top into that. And then all the ones under the spaceman, let's group those. Call them glass bottom. I've got all of our glass in place. That is looking pretty good. Okay, the next thing I'm going to do is right on top of the space window here, I'm going to add a pixel layer, change it to overlay, grab my brush. I want a nice soft brush again. The color I want to be red. So red, and my flow, I'm going to have it about 10-15%. Let's go 15%. Really big brush. Just going to paint some red around these areas here, like there's some sort of alarms going off and everything's red. So just like that, looks pretty good. Maybe drop that opacity a little bit. So that looks pretty good at the moment. I'm pretty happy with that. What I might do now is just grab this picture of this alien. I just want the top of the alien. So I'm just going to use my rectangular marquee tool. Just grab the head here, Command C, back to my picture and where my astronaut is, or my spaceman, right on top there, Command V, just in there. Let's change that to screen, grabbing our move tool and just make it a lot smaller, right in the helmet there, right in the front of the helmet. Let's grab a mask and put the mask on our brush, low about 20%, I would say, down to 20. Make sure we're painting in black. Zoom in, and it's going to be like this is the last face that the spaceman's seen as he flies out of the window. So let's just blend that in there. Just blend that in like that as he flies out the window. That's the last face he's seeing. Command 0 to make that a little bit bigger. Might even be able to drop the opacity a little bit down to about 75. That looks pretty good. And a couple more little things just to finish this off. Let's add another pixel layer on top of the spaceman here. Again, let's change that to overlay. On our brush, still a nice soft brush, but let's change our flow to about 5%. Let's just add a little bit of that red, maybe here, where we might be getting the reflection of those buttons there. Just down the side there, that looks pretty good. Again, we can turn that down a little bit if it's too much. And let's highlight the top one here, click on that, all the way down to the bottom with our shift key. Let's come up here to layer and merge visible. And this week on this one, I will use the tone mapping. You can use the develop persona if you want, but let's go with the tone mapping this week. Let's click on the detailed one, bringing our tone all the way down to about 10%. Let's bring our exposure down as well. A little bit of contrast. And let's hit apply. So there you go, everybody. That is my tutorial for this week. I hope you have enjoyed it. If you have, please give it a thumbs up. Please consider subscribing to my channel. Don't forget, you can head over to the Buy Me a Coffee site if you'd like to show your appreciation and grab some of the free assets that I have on the Buy Me a Coffee site. This week, I will have the spaceman and the space window already cut out for you. You can grab those absolutely free. And as usual, all of the pictures that I have used will be in the links below. So until next time, stay well, stay safe, and I'll see you in my next video.